Hi everyone, welcome to my video. For a couple months I wanted to do a herringbone design in my bathroom. As you can see, the original wall is very plain, very simple, no design whatsoever, and I had space. I had a little quirks here and there because of the window and the cabinet. So I had looked at a video before doing this, and the recommendation was, of course, you know, to tape up all of your wall, cover anything that could actually get stained. So I started by using a ruler to separate in between the layers of tape, and that kind of made it a little bit uniform, but the intention wasn't it to be perfect, because it's really hard to get it perfect, at least for me it was. So I kind of used the ruler as a separation between all of the tapes. It got to a point where I noticed that it was actually super crooked, so I had to like remove it and then tape it back up again. I didn't measure the whole wall before doing it. I kind of did it by eye, sort of, because again, I didn't want it to be perfect, but to be functional, you could potentially measure all of it and then do it that way. While I was moving along the wall, so you can notice, I started to then tape up around the window to make sure the paint didn't, you know, get into the window itself or the window cover. I could have removed the towel hanger, but it really wasn't in the way of the tape, so I decided to leave it like that. Again, I also wanted it to have some sort of imperfection as I was doing this. And the other part, you can't really see it because the door doesn't open more than that, because the toilet is on that side. But I taped up the whole wall from side to side. And then now you can see, well, when the tape was done and I was almost ready to go to start painting, I then realized that I needed to actually take the ruler and apply paint on it. But I had already started it. I started part of the wall. I was doing by just using the ruler with a foam paintbrush. And then it was getting a little messy. Some lines were too thick. On that side, I wasn't too smart about it. I should be ashamed because I'm an engineer. But it was hard to figure out how to get there. So I just used the angle on the right and then sort of eyed it on the left side towards closer to the wall. I don't know if you can see in the video, but I actually did make some mistakes and I ended up painting the white wall. So again, I then realized I should tape up the ruler and then use it with the painter's tape. That really helped. That's why you see that the first and second row is a little bit thicker, and then the second and third going forward were a little bit slimmer, I could say, in a certain way. And then, you know, after doing the whole thing, I was removing the tape as I was finishing certain rows. As you can see, some, you know, the ones on the left are a little bit thicker, but at the end of the day, I was super happy with the result. I had to cover up a few of them and then touch them back up again, but I am extremely happy with the result. This is the ruler, or triangle as it's called, that I mentioned. I bought it on Amazon and I just taped up one side. And these are the brushes that I bought in Home Depot. They're really inexpensive.